This year, an unwelcome presence looms large over all of our Thanksgivings. Oh, how I long for those childhood Thanksgivings when the only unwelcome presence at Thanksgiving was the Brussels sprouts, which, thanks to my mom, always managed to make their way onto my plate. If only the coronavirus was as easy to deal with as those Brussels sprouts. As a child, I became quite adept at swallowing those little suckers whole so that I didn't have to bite into them and have their flavor invade my senses. I'd take one look at the obligatory Brussels sprouts on my plate, take a deep breath, and pop them in my mouth, and down they went one at a time. Fortunately for me, my mom was a cook from a different generation who always boiled vegetables into mush, so there was no fear of choking on a soggy Brussels sprout. This Thanksgiving, the unwelcome presence of a global pandemic is keeping us from gathering together in our homes with family and friends. Most of us will sit down with only the people we live with, no invited guests, no visiting family, no tables filled to overflowing with loved ones. Small turkeys rather than large ones were all the rage in the grocery stores this week. Over Zoom, I have heard people lament the empty spaces which will dominate our Thanksgiving celebrations. Like the lepers who failed to give thanks for their healing, some of us may even be tempted to give Thanksgiving a miss this year. I know. We do indeed have so very much to be thankful for. A small turkey is better than no turkey. A small gathering is better than no gathering. The lingering presence of COVID is better than having COVID. We are so very blessed. We have so very much to be thankful for. We have roofs over our heads, food on our tables, technology to connect us, and most of us are healthy. We have the means to protect ourselves from the lingering presence of COVID, and should we find ourselves testing positive, we are blessed to live in a country where our medical needs will be met without question. In a worldwide pandemic, Canadians are blessed to have the odds in our favor. We have so very much to be thankful for. We ought to be among the first to offer our thanks and praise. I suspect if the questions I've received from some of you over the course of this week leading up to Thanksgiving are anything to go by, I suspect that some of us may be keeping company with the nine lepers who failed to offer thanks and praise to God. This Thanksgiving is much like other Thanksgivings in that way. When folks have asked me a perplexing question, how or to whom do progressives give our thanks? Over the years, many of us have moved beyond the old images which personified the divine mystery, which we call God, as a person, a superhero kind of super person. Who am I kidding? Those old images personified God as an old man in the sky who enjoyed various omni superpowers. The omni God was omnipotent, omniscient, and omnipresent, all powerful, all-knowing, and always and everywhere present. A sky god is the same god which so many people conjure up when they tell me they don't believe in God. To which I usually reply, I don't believe in the same God which you don't believe in. This image of the divine mystery falls far short of the one in whom we live and move and have our being, the one who is being itself. So how or to whom do we give thanks and praise when we no longer think of God as a superhero up there or out there who functions as a kind of master puppeteer in the sky? I will admit that it is so much easier to say thank you to a deity that we have personified than it is to give thanks to a deity which is beyond the beyond and beyond that also. Our thank yous to the one in whom we live and move and have our being tend to be expressed in words which are so much more awkward than simply saying, thank you, Father, or thank you, Lord, or even thank God. I've said it before many times, so let me say this again. There is absolutely nothing wrong with personifying the mystery which lies at the very heart of reality. Humans personify things or entities that we have relationships with. Personification of stuff or ideas or entities beyond our ability to name or comprehend is a way of relating to what lies beyond our very selves. There is nothing wrong with personifying the divine mystery which we call God, unless we forget that our personification is a personification, and we begin to worship it instead of the one who is beyond our personifications. Let me say that again, because it is really important. There is nothing wrong with personifying the divine mystery which we call God, unless we forget that our personification is a personification, and we begin to worship it instead of the one who is beyond our personifications. When it comes to the divine mystery, which is the source of all being, language fails us. Even a simple thank God begs the question as to what we mean by the word God. Sadly, when folks hear the word God, all too often images of a supreme being who demands our thanks and praise comes to mind, and we find ourselves bowing before an idol of our own making. Learning to love the one who is beyond the beyond and beyond that also, with all our hearts, with all our souls, and with all our minds, is a tall order. But it is nothing new to those who since the beginning of time have sought to move beyond the worship of idols. The ancient Greek noun for God is theos. We get our word theology from this. Theology means words or ideas about God. The ancient noun theos was derived from the Greek verb theo, which means to flow. Our ancestors described the divine mystery as the light which flows through all things. Jesus' life, his teachings, and his death proclaim that God is love. As followers of Jesus, surely we can begin to understand the divine source as the love which flows through all things. Our language may fail us. So of late, I have begun to express my thanks to the one who is beyond words with the phrase, thanks be to all that is holy, precisely because all things are in God and God is in all things. The word panentheism is used to describe the divine in ways which try to capture the notion that everything is in God and God is in everything, while at the same time recognizing that God is more than the sum of everything. God is beyond the beyond and beyond that also. Thanks be to all that is holy. As followers of Jesus, let us remember that the one Jesus called Abba is love. This love flows through all things. So let our Thanksgiving celebrations open us to the reality of our many blessings, and let those blessings flow through us. Let our thanksgivings give birth to gratitude as we gratefully and graciously respond to our blessings by embodying love in the world. May our God, who is love, flow in, with, through, and beyond us so that everyone may know the love in whom we live and move and have our being by our love. Let them know who we are by our love. Let us remember that love flows both ways. Just as surely as our blessings flow through us, so too the pain of our sisters and brothers flows, for we are one. If the coronavirus teaches us anything, surely it reminds us that we are intimately connected one to another. Humanity is suffering, and the balm, the medicine which can soothe the pain which we are all in together, is the love which lies at the very heart of all that is, flowing in, with, through, and beyond us. Thanks be to all that is holy. Over the years, I learned to love Brussels sprouts when they are cooked properly. In the endless flow of this life, nothing stays the same, for life without change is death, which in and of itself is change. We are richly blessed. This year, we may not be giving thanks for all the blessings we usually give thanks for, but we are still richly blessed. So let us give thanks to all that is holy. Let the love in which we live and move and have our being flow in, with, through, and beyond us, now and forever. Thanks be to all that is holy. Amen.
We hope that you have found this broadcast to be of value to you at this time. To continue to offer these, we depend on the support of donors. If you wish to help to keep us going, please donate what feels right for you via Canada Helps to Holy Cross Lutheran Church, Newmarket. Peace be with you.